Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to this new episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Cloud Advocate, and today I want to show you how you could follow every penny consumed by your last application in Azure using the Cost Management. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. So you just published your last application, but you're worried that you will receive a huge invoice at the end of the month. With this video, I want to show you how you could monitor one application or a full subscription using the cost management. So here I have a very simple web application that I did. Very simple. You could, you know, create some blue shade thing. Let's say I had the color blue azure. See what I did there? So, very simple application using a few resources, a database, and things like that. In fact, let me show you what I used. So, this is the Azure Portal, so portal.azure.com, and here are the resources I'm using. So, it's a app service. I use also Application Insight to get all the information about my application. I have a database that is running as a service, so I don't need to manage it. I have a service plan and I have some storage. So I want to visualize and monitor all that consumption for this application. All this application was deployed in the one resource group called Cloud 5-Minute Cost Management Demo. So I want to track everything that is inside this. So before we get started, let's just create a dashboard. I will explain why it could be useful after. So to create dashboard, you go here at the root, at the top left, and you select dashboard. Now you click this button, new dashboard here, and you just give it a name. So let's call the blues, because my website showed different shade of blues. Perfect. So now I have a new dashboard. We'll come back to it later. So now let's find this cost management page. So I could go here top left corner and look for it. Maybe it's not there, maybe it's not available. So what I can do is type here and just type cost management and I should find it. So great. So now I'm in the cost management. Cost management is bunch of tools, so it's a toolbox that will help you to plan, visualize, and optimize your resources in Azure. And it's all related to money, of course. So there's plenty of tools and resources, and in fact, at the end of the video, I will also share you a lot of links where you could learn more about cost management, see what's coming, and even try them before. But for today, what I want to show you is those tools here. So cost analysis, cost alert, and budget. So let's start with cost analysis. So it will show my subscription. We see here in the scope, that's the name of my subscription. It's a subscription that I use to create demos. And there's a few resources available here. Of course, I already have some views created for me. So right now I'm in the accumulated cost, but I can switch and go, let's say, cost by resources. And every time I found something interesting, I could pin it. But remember, what we were looking for is to see the resources and focus on my application. So what you can do here is add a filter here. And now you have plenty of options, but in our case, we'll use the resource group name. We'll just select the one we are interested. So Cloud 5-Minute Cost Center Demo. Now I have the information for my application. So since I'm interested, I will pin that. So I will pin using this pin board here, and that will go add this chart to my dashboard. We'll go back later. We'll just pin a few more. So let's say right now I would like to have a daily cost. So again, that's cool. I have my daily costs, but it's for all my subscription. So what I want to do here, again, I will go there, say by group name, and I will select my resource group. So that's perfect. We see it's very recent. I just deployed this thing. Of course, you could do it when you have resources that already exist, but you know, if you want to track as day one, you could just go there and do those things. So that's great. I have a lot of information and now I will be able to track it, but I don't want to go every time into the portal and do all those clicks. So what I can do is save this request. So I could click here to save as and give it a name. So let's call it the My Daily. And I could make it private if I want. The beauty of this is all based on Active Directory. So you could give very specific permission on who can see what kind of information in those reports. So that's pretty cool. Let's also pin it, don't forget that. And if you want to use this report inside, for example, a PowerPoint or a document, you could export it. So what you could do here is click that export button, and now you could export it as an image, PNG, or an Excel file or CSV file to treat it in another source of information. I don't know, maybe Power BI. You could even do a schedule export, so every day or every week or once a month, extract the information, put that in a blob storage or somewhere else, and then another process will start from there and process it. So that's really cool, and now you could customize all those views. Before we go back to the dashboard, let's switch and see how the cost alert and budget works together. So let's switch to cost alert and we'll create a new cost alert. So to create one, we'll click the add button, and now I see the scope, it's my full subscription, but I just want a specific alert for that application. So again, same thing, we'll add a filter, we'll use, and again, you could use many different kind of filter here. I'm just always using the same because my focus today is for a specific application. So that's perfect. So now I have it. So let's see, monthly blue max. That's the name of my budget. So it will be a monthly, but I could go quarterly or annually if I want, have different kind of budget and alerts. And now I could set an expiration date if it's just the beginning that I'm worried about, or if it's a long term. Of course, you can edit them after. And then you will put a limit. So let's say 100 bucks for me. It's a simple application, and honestly, I don't have the impression that my shade of blue will be that popular. So then if I go next, now I'm creating an alert. So I would say, you know what, when I'm at 50% of my budget, I want to do something. So application. And now if I am at 90, I want to also do something else. Add someone in an email list, or multiple people if you want. And then you have a lot of information. Right now, since my application is very new, nothing is shown here, but of course, if it's an application that exists for a little bit longer, you have more data available. So now you created, it will validate that the email is an official one and everything is okay. And you will have created your first budget and alert. Perfect. Budget was created. Excellent. So now I have a few information, but that's pretty cool when I'm in the portal. But let's see the dashboard that we create. So again, to see the dashboard, we just click here and the dashboard on the top. So now I have my dashboard. Remember, I click on the source and my daily. That was my specific query that I did. Of course, you can be more creative. So let me show you another one that I create. So that's the one I created before. So again, the by day, the accumulated costs. Maybe I want to see the cost by review. Maybe I want to see the accumulated costs through my subscription. So in a dashboard, you could mix everything. So this is a view where I compare my other resources to my specific application. And then you could add a markdown. So have an image or something, information, some information, support number, everything you want. And I even here put some application inside dashboard to visualize. And now I see that my application, in fact, is having some trouble and I should have a look at it. That was pretty quick because my focus was just to show you the point of the iceberg, showing you that is possible. But if you want to learn more, you should definitely go to the MS module. There's a small module, very quick to do, but it will show you everything that is possible to plan, visualize, and optimize your resources in Azure. So the link should appear somewhere, but I will put all links also in the description. Another very nice place is this Cost Management Labs, where you could try in preview every new feature that is coming up. And lucky for you, Cost Management is also available on YouTube, and you have a lot of videos available there, so you should subscribe. So I hope you liked this video, and I hope it was useful. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to write them in the questions. And talking about questions, let's see what I have this week. So the first question this week comes from Sean, and he's asking, if I have one repo for a Visual Studio solution that contains a web app deploying an Azure app service and a number of different Azure function projects, can I configure this CI/CD such as one check-in that the repo will deploy all resources in their respective destination? Of course you can, Sean. For that, I will suggest using an ARM template to create all the resources and then have a few action, a few steps that will deploy every of those solutions. So there's no problem for that. You can definitely go check also how I build my CI/CD in another video I did. I will put the link somewhere and I hope it helps you. So the next question comes from Steven Penna. He's asking, what is the Visual Studio Code extension that populate those resources and update all those properties as you type? So, Steven, I'm using the official Azure Resource Manager ARM template tool available, and I will put the link in the description. I use that all the time. It's a huge time saver and very, 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 very useful. The product team is also working very hard to add new feature in that extension, so it's definitely something you should install and keep up to date. Thank you for watching. To know more about cost management, you could go on their channel just over here or here another video of Cloud in 5 minutes. See you next time. Bye. I'm done now. You could go. Anytime.